Alright, it's the kid Mikey Fresh, all hip hop in the building with Nipsey Hussle.
Yeah, yeah, what's happening with it, y'all?
Nah, what's going on, man?
Trying to get it, man. Same program.
Now, how's it feel to be in Manhattan, man? In Epic Records, 22nd floor, like.
We on right now. You feel me? Popping. It's cold as fuck outside, but you know, we working right now. We in the building, working on the solo debut, working on the mixtapes, just grinding it out.
Yeah, and the record you got with Game is popping right now, all over the board.
No question.
I mean, how was it working with the Game?
Game is A1. Game, like, it's inspiring working with Game because he really a creative person. Like, motherfuckers don't give him the credit he deserves. Game is really a beast in the studio. And, like, you know, the session we did my record in, he did like 3 records ahead of mine. Then we hopped in, knocked my shit out, and I just seen how dude worked. Now, you know what I'm saying? How focused Cuz was. So, like, it was A1. I learned something from that session, no doubt.
Word. And, you know, yesterday was a big day. Obama was inaugurated into office.
Yeah.
I mean, were you watching that? What are your thoughts on that whole thing?
I caught the tail end of it. I didn't see the whole inauguration just because I was busy. I was kind of running around. But like, I told everybody, like, I never thought I'd see that day. Even after he won, even after he was getting close to winning. And I seen all the publicity around it in the campaign. And I was like, I couldn't even trick myself into thinking it was going to fly. And then when they said he won, it was like a shock. And to see him getting sworn in, you know what I mean? It's obviously a positive change for the country. You know what I mean? Not even just because he's black, just because of what he represents, his politics and the way he articulates. You know what I mean? We could finally have a president that actually, you could relate to what he's saying, and you could feel like he's looking out for your best interest. So, from that angle, I feel like it's A1 to have Obama in office. And due to his ethnicity, it shows where the country's at.
So you really think this is some change that could happen sometime soon, or is it going to be a while?
I mean, shit, he didn't close Guantanamo Bay this morning. I'm looking at CNN, they talking about Obama closes Guantanamo Bay.
Oh, well, that's crazy. I didn't even hear about that.
You know, he steadily moving down the list. You feel me? All you got to do is a couple more things, in my opinion. Drastic changes, and he'll have the country, you know what I mean, full support. You know what I mean? Without a doubt. He got mine, though.
Got Nipsey Hussle support.
Yeah, no question.
And being that, you know, what's that?
I said I voted for Obama.
Okay.
No, I ain't voted since I was old enough to vote. It's the first election I went out and voted just because I felt like it was necessary.
All right, and being that, you know, we're in Manhattan right now, New York City. What's some of the things that you love about New York and some of the things that you hate about New York, just can't stand about this city? Because, you know, born and raised on Crenshaw and Slauson.
I can't stand these cold-ass days. I can't stand these racist taxi cab drivers that ain't trying to stop for
them. Can't get a cab?
Yeah, man. I can't stand. I mean, really, that's it, the cabs and the weather. Everything else about New York, I love. I love how everything is open all night. You know what I'm saying? This shit don't stop. The clubs stay open till 4. Everybody work hard, 24/7, everybody grinding. Nobody just relax. Like, L.A. kind of got a chronic and a sunshiny weather type of attitude. Like, niggas is laid back and relaxed. In New York, like, 100 miles an hour, niggas trying to get to the top floor of one of these buildings. So, like, that's the part I love about it, the energy and the grind.
I know. Cali, and you from the land of the chronic, the land of the kush.
Yeah,
New York's a little different, you know. It's more of piff over here. You smoking good out here, or
yeah,
how's...
I fuck with Purple City, Shice Buzz. That's my nigga, so you know, I stay on deck, man. It ain't a problem. I smoke in New York like I smoke in L.A.
Same thing?
Yeah, without a doubt. No question.
All right. Yo, if you had 15 bucks in your pocket and you had to cop some shit from the Slauson swap meet, what are 5 things you would cop?
I'm going to get a wife beater, a pair of socks, an extra large tarp, pro club.
Okay.
That's 5. That's damn near the whole
thing. Is that 15 right there?
You know what I'm saying? And with the change, you're going to clean your gold off or something. You feel me? Get the rollie shined up or something. Other than that, that's about all you're going to do for $15. All
right. And if you had to take, like, a New York chick out on a first date in Cali, you going to Roscoe's? You going to Fatburger? Where you going?
A New York chick? Yeah, I might take her to Roscoe's. We might do Roscoe's.
Is that a good first date?
Yeah, that'll work. You know, Roscoe's crack. It all depends on the female. She might take me out. You feel me? It might be all right. I don't know.
All right, that's what it is. All hip-hop, Mikey Fresh, Nipsey Hussle. We out of here.
Yeah, off top. Like, boy, in the puzzle.